Sigma FP camera, a short development update.
Cinema 5D at IBC 2019 is brought to you by B&H, the professional source for all your video needs. CVP, the leading specialist in creative cine, video, and photo solutions. Fomex, devoted to remarkable light. Manfrotto, imagine more. And Fujinon, ultimate optical performance.
Hi, I'm Johnny from Cinema 5D, and I'm here with Yamaki-san from Sigma. Yamaki-san, how are you?
Good, thank you very much. How are you?
Thank you. It's always a pleasure to talk and see you again. And actually, what I would like to do is a recap and find out where is the development of the FP camera right now, because of course this is a very interesting tool. So where do we stand with the camera? Last time it was a big announcement and you already showed kind of working prototypes. Where are we now?
We have already done all the hardware. So we have already started the production, but we are still working on the software side, I mean the firmware. We are very close to the beta version. And then after beta version, we will be able to finish the firmware not too long time.
When do you think you will be delivering the camera if you are so close to finalizing everything?
We are aiming to release within this fall, autumn time.
Okay. Technically speaking, when I saw it for the first time in Japan, there were a lot of questions right after. For example, cinema DNG, internal recording, is it possible now with the camera?
Yes, it's possible, but it's limit up to the 8-bit, 24 frame per second.
Okay, and if you would like to record externally to an external device, then the bit depth is higher?
Yes, 12-bit and 24 frame per second.
Okay, that's about the compressed RAW, but from what I remember, there was also no a flat picture profile, which is a bit easier to color correct later. Are you considering adding a flat picture profile also?
We are aware of such a request from the users, but let us focus on the finalizing the firmware of the first version. And then after that, we like to study that kind of feedback from the users.
Okay. One more thing that I noticed, and that's of course hardware related, the camera did not have any headphone jack. Will you be introducing any accessory or model that actually allow people to monitor the sound?
We hope some other companies prepare the accessory for our FP camera.
And the whole concept of the camera, something very, very small, yet very modular, with so many nice accessories around it. Where is the idea coming from?
It was about 3 years ago that I had made such a basic plan for Sigma FP, which I personally wanted to own. And then I shared the idea with the engineer, and then we made that the concept of the camera together.
So in your photo cameras, you're having the foveon sensor, and many people were asking why you're actually not using the same sensor in this current model. I mean, this is now a CMOS sensor. What is the reason?
Foveon sensor has a challenge in the high-speed readout. As you know, we have to read out the three data from one pixel. So if we keep the higher resolution, we need to implement a three times higher readout speed, which is very challenging. So right now, we consider foveon for the still camera, and then we use the regular Bayer sensor for this kind of FP camera.
From your studying, and I'm of course will be very curious how it will evolve, because the FP camera can do video and still pictures.
Yes.
From your studying, what do you think people will use it most, for photos or for videos?
Well, I assume the majority of the users use still photo, because the photo market is much bigger than video cine market. But I really hope the professionals, the high-end video cinematographers, use our FP camera?
The thing is, for me personally, the camera is very small, which I do appreciate a lot. I'm a small guy. I like lightweight equipment. But the thing is with the lenses, and this has an L-mount lens, the lenses are still big and heavy. Is there any way to consider making, let's say, pancake L-mount lenses, or this is technically, I will not ever use the word impossible, but challenging?
Technically, it's not very difficult to make a pancake lens for L-mount lens, but making the pancake lens is kind of different story. And we don't have the plan to make a pancake lens for L-mount, but in the future we may have it, that kind of lens. But our 45mm, new 45mm f2.8 is compact enough for FP camera, and we will probably have that size of lenses in the future.
Okay, Yamaki-san, and of course I have to ask, because many, many people were commenting about the price, which is not announced yet. Any ballpark, something that you can let the people know? Because of course it's a very important factor. Cameras are becoming better, but also less expensive with time. Maybe you can share with us a little bit?
I always try to be open and honest to you, but this time I can't comment on it. But I don't want to price too high so that not many people cannot use. So we would like to do our best to deliver as many customers as possible.
Yamaki-san, as always, thank you very much. It's always a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you, guys.